This is a LibriVox recording. All LibriVox recordings are in the public domain. For more information for how you can volunteer, please visit LibriVox.org. Poems by Gerard Manley Hopkins. Read by Linda Liu. Part 2. Poem 5. Penman Pool. For the visitor's book at the inn. Who long for rest, who look for pleasure, away from counter, court, or school, or where live well your lease of leisure, but here at Penman Pool. You'll dare the Alp, you'll dart the skiff, each sport has here its tackle and tool. Come, plant the staff by Kader Cliff. Come, swing the sculls on Penman Pool. What's yonder? Grizzled Dyfwise dim, the triple hummock giant stool, whore messmate, hobs and knobs with him, to have the bull of Penman Pool. In all the landscape under survey, at tranquil turns by nature's rule, rise repeated topsy-turvy in frank and fairy Penman Pool. And Charles Wayne, the wondrous seven, and sheep flock clouds like worlds of wool, for all they shine so high in heaven, show brighter shaken in Penman Pool. The Modditch, how she trips, though throttled, if flood tide teeming thrills her full, and mazy sands, all water waddled, waylay her at ebb past Penman Pool. But what's to see in stormy weather, when gray showers gather and gusts are cool? Why, raindrop roundels loop together that lace the face of Penman Pool. Then even in weariest wintry hour of New Year's month or surly Yule furred snows, charged tuft above tuft, tower from darksome, darksome Penman Pool. And ever, if bound here hardest home, you've parlor pastime left, and who'll not honor it? Ale like goldy foam that frocks an oar in Penman Pool. Then come who pine for peace or pleasure, away from counter, court, or school. Spend here your measure of time and treasure, and taste the treats of Penman Pool. Poem 6. The Silver Jubilee. To James, first Bishop of Shrewsbury, on the 25th year of his episcopate, July 28, 1876. 1. Though no high-hung bells or din of braggart bugles cry it in, what is sound? Nature's round makes a silver jubilee. 2. 25 years have run since sacred fountains to the sun sprang, that but now were shot, showering silver jubilee. 3. Feasts, when we shall fall asleep, Shrewsbury may see others keep, none but you this her true, this her silver jubilee. 4. Not today we need lament, your wealth of life is some way spent. Toil has shed round your head silver but for jubilee. 5. Then for whose velvet veils should have pealed with welcome wails, let the chime of a rhyme utter silver jubilee. Poem 7. God's Grandeur. The world is charged with the grandeur of God. It will flame out of like shining from shook foil, gathers to a greatness like the ooze of oil, crushed. Why do men then now not wreck his rod? Generations have trod, have trod, have trod, and all is seared with trade, bleared, smeared with toil. And where is man's smudge, and shares man's smell? The soil is bare now, nor can foot feel being shod. And for all this, nature is never spent. There lives the dearest freshness deep down things, and though the last lights off the black west went, O morning, at the brown brink eastward, springs, because the Holy Ghost over the bent world broods with warm breast and with, bright wings. Poem 8, The Starlight Night. Look at the stars. Look, look up at the skies. Oh, look at all the fire folk sitting in the air. Bright borals, the circle citadels there. Down in dim woods, the diamond delves, the elves' eyes, the gray lawns cold where gold, where quick gold lies. Wind beat white beam, Ariabella's set on a flare. Flake doves sent floating forth at a farmyard scare. Ah, well. It is all a purchase, all is a prize. Buy then, bid then, what? Prayer, patience, aims, vows. Look, look, a May mess, like on orchard boughs. Look, March bloom, like on mealed with yellow sallows. These are indeed the barn, within doors house the shocks. This peace bright paling shuts a spouse, Christ, home, Christ and his mother and all his hallows. Poem 9, Spring. Nothing is so beautiful as spring, when weeds and wheels shoot long and lovely and lush, thrush's eggs look little low heavens, and thrush through the echoing timber does so rinse and ring the ear, it strikes like lightnings to hear him sing. The glassy pear tree leaves and blooms, they brush the descending blue, that blue is all in a rush with richness. The racing lambs too have fair their fling. What is all this juice and all this joy? A strain of the earth's sweetness being in the beginning in Eden Garden. Have, get, before it cloy, before it cloud, Christ, Lord, and sour with sinning. Innocent mind and May day and girl and boy, most, O maid's child, thy choice and worthy the winning. Poem 10. The lantern out of doors. Sometimes a lantern moves along the night that interests our eyes. And who goes there, I think, where from and bound, I wonder, where? With all down darkness wide, his waiting light. Men go by me whom either beauty bright in mold or mind or what not else makes rare. They rain against our much thick and marsh air, rich beams, till death or distance buys them quite. Death or distance soon consumes them. Wind, what most I may eye after, be in at the end I cannot, and out of sight is out of mind. Christ minds, Christ's interest, what to avow or amend there, eyes them, heart wants, care haunts, foot follows kind. Their ransom, their rescue, and first, fast, last friend. Poem 11, The Sea and the Skylark. On ear and ear, two noises, too old to end. Trench, right, the tide that ramps against the shore, with a flood or a fall, low Lolof or all roar, frequenting there while moon shall wear and wend. Left hand, off land, I hear the lark ascend, his rash fresh, rewinded, new-skeened score, in crisp of curl off wild wind whirl, and pour and pelt music, till none's to spill nor spend. How these two shame this shallow and frail town, how ring right our sordid turbid time, being pure. We, life's pride and cared for crown, have lost that cheer and charm of earth's past prime. Our make and making break, our breaking down to man's last dust, drain fast towards man's first slime. Poem 12, The Windover. To Christ our Lord. I caught this morning, morning's minion, kingdom of daylight dolphin, dapple dawn drawn falcon, in his riding of the rolling level, underneath him steady air, and striding high there, how he rung upon the reen of a wimpling wing in his ecstasy, then off, off forth on swing, as a skate's heel sweeps smooth on a bow bend, the hurl and gliding rebuff the big wind, my heart in hiding, stirred for a bird, the achieve of, the mastery of the thing, brute beauty and valor in act, oh air, pride, plume, here, buckle, and the fire that breaks from thee then, a billion times told lovelier, more dangerous, oh my chevalier, no wonder of it. Sheer plod makes plow down sillion shine, and blue bleak embers, ah, my dear, fall, gall themselves, and gash gold vermilion. Poem 13, Pied Beauty. Glory be to God for dappled things, for skies of couple color as a brinded cow, for rose moles all in stipple upon trout that swim, fresh fire coal, chestnut falls, finches' wings, landscape plotted and pieced, fold, fallow, and plow, and all trades, their gear and tackle and trim, all things counter, original, spare, strange, whatever is fickle, freckled, who knows how, with swift, slow, sweet, sour, a dazzle, dim, he fathers forth whose beauty is past change. Praise him. Poem 14, Hurrahing in Harvest. Summer ends now, now, barbarous in beauty, the stooks arise, around, up above, what wind walks, what lovely behavior of silt sack clouds, has wilder, willful wavier, meal drift molded ever and melted across skies. I walk, I lift up heart, eyes, down all that glory in the heavens to glean our Savior. And eyes, heart, what looks, what lips yet gave you a rapturous love's greeting of realer, of rounder replies? And the azurous-hung hills are as world-wielding shoulder, majestic as a stallion stalwart, very violet sweet. These things were here and but the beholder wanting, which two, when they once meet, the heart rears wings bold and bolder, and hurls for him, oh half hurls earth for him under his feet. End of part 2. This recording is in the public domain.